Hi there, folks, and welcome back. Okay, so before Christmas, I watched a video where a guy was using one of these phones, a Ulefone Armor 24. He was using the phone as a hammer. Not only was he using the phone as a hammer, he was hammering nails in with the actual screen of this phone, of one of these Armor 24 phones. Now, there was another video in the suggested videos in the sidebar, and I went and had a look, and there was another guy doing all sorts of crazy stuff with one of these. He was freezing it in the freezer, using the screen as a hammer, and he was doing the same sort of abusive things to the phone as what the other guy was in the first video that I was watching. And I actually left a comment on this video saying, I don't believe that this phone is all that you're cracking it up to be. So I was contacted by somebody called Yin from Ulefone. And he offered me a deal on one, so long as I would do a review. And I said to him, if I'm going to do a review, it's going to be an honest review, okay? I'm not one of these people that takes on, you know, deals from manufacturers and stuff and then sings the praises and this sort of stuff if it's a load of garbage. If it's garbage, I will say it's garbage. Anyway, I came to an arrangement with him and he sent me one out, this one. So today I'm going to unbox this phone and just take a quick look at it and basically give you my initial thoughts on the phone. And in the next few days or coming weeks, I'm going to do some proper reviews of it because this phone has got some amazing features which I want to test out, namely the camera, the night vision and all this sort of thing. So let's just have a little quick hands-on look at this phone, shall we? And let's have a look at the build quality of it. Now, I've taken the cellophane off the box because I didn't want to have to fiddle around with that. So yeah, let's open this box together and have a look, shall we? Right. Oh yes. Oh yeah. It's a very, very heavy phone, I will say that. Now, one thing I did notice with this box was it felt very, very, very tough and hard. Listen to this. This thing is rock hard. If the phone, if this box is anything to go by, if the phone is as tough as this box, yeah. Yeah, it could well be. I can't believe it. Listen to that. That's like knocking on solid. That is a solid box. Unbelievable. So what do you get in this box? Right. So you get the Ulefone envelope. And in there, from all the other unboxing videos of this I've looked at, you get Gorilla Glass protective screen. But the phone already comes with one fitted, so you get a spare one. And you get all the operating manuals and all the information about all the extras you can get for this phone. And I'll tell you what, I've seen some good manuals in my time. But yeah, this looks absolutely superb. It's far more superior than what I got with my Xiaomi telephone. And it's also got its ring and what have you for opening up the slot for your SIM cards and storage. Yeah, absolutely fantastic. Yeah, so you've got all your guides and everything in there. Looks fantastic. Right, this phone. This thing is an absolute brick. Listen to that. That is solid as a rock, and it's heavy. Weighs about 1.5 pounds by the weight of it. But this isn't just a phone, it's also a power pack. So let's take this out of here, out of its plastic protective cover, and let's have a proper look at this. All right, let's slide that out of there. Oh yeah, that's lovely. The build quality of this feels absolutely superb. I watched a stripped down video of one of these, a guy tearing one down to have a look inside. And the absolute bulk of this phone is made out of metal. It's made out of aluminium billet, actually. So the cradle that holds the power pack inside here, the battery pack, is an aluminium cradle. The frame and everything all inside is all aluminium. This outer frame and everything's all metal. And it's solid. And it's got like a rubber body, rubberized body on it as well. Got two cameras on the back, 64 megapixel wide angle camera. And you've got a night vision camera there as well. This light here is 510 LEDs, 1,000 lumens. That is bright. Yeah. So you've got a dedicated button. You can program this button to do certain things. You've got your card slot. This button here controls the light on the back. You got your volume rocker here, up and down. You got your fingerprint sensor there. And on the top, you got a headphone socket under here. Yeah, headphone socket, jack, 3.5 mil. Your charging port is in the bottom. You got an IR blaster in the top as well. So this can actually be a remote control for your telly and all this type of stuff. It's waterproof 1.5 meters. I believe up to 35 minutes or something like that. It can go underwater, so it's waterproof. It's dust proof. And the build quality feels absolutely beautiful. Absolutely beautiful build quality. But it's really, really heavy. So, yeah. My initial thoughts on this is it's a brick, but it could actually end up being like the ultimate biker phone, and I'll tell you why momentarily. Right, what else we got in this box here? So what else comes in the box? Obviously you've got your carry strap, you've got your charging cable, USB-C both ends. You've got a 66 watt charger, but I'll have to get one of the little 2-pin plug converters for 3-pin because this is a Euro plug. Yeah, 66 watt charging, absolutely brilliant. So that's what's in the box. Yeah, but my first impression of this is it's a brick. But this could actually be like, as far as I'm concerned, for me personally, this could actually be like the ultimate biker phone. For the simple reason is it is so strong, it's so rugged. And the battery life on it is phenomenal. I mean, it's a 22,000 milliamp hour battery. 22,000 milliamp hour. Yeah, so it's a battery pack. You can reverse charge off this as well. I believe at 12 watts or something like that, I think it is, you can charge up other phones and GoPros and stuff, which would be brilliant for me when I'm traveling, because when this is fully charged, I'll be able to charge my GoPro and stuff off of it and still have power to run the phone. This thing has like 52 days, I think it is, or 54 days of standby. That's nearly 2 months on standby. You got 100 hours of talk time. Like 100 hours of talk time on the telephone, and you got 33 hours of video playback. Apparently these are not half bad for gaming too. So one of my friends bought one of these after I mentioned it, and he's singing its praises already. On the side here, it's got this facility down here for particular extras. You can get an endoscope that can go on this, a microscope. There's also a handle with an endoscope on it, which you can remotely, you know, turn and move the endoscope around when you've got it inside objects. This for me is brilliant. I mean, this unbelievable, because, you know, this could be like the ultimate biker phone, mechanics phone, if you want to look down inside the ports and stuff on motorcycles, you know, inside the barrels and what have you. With the endoscope, you can do it. You just connect it up to the phone. It's all there on the screen. Amazing. And also a microscope. So what I'm going to do is, So you guys, I'm not going to sit here and rabbit on about all of its functions and everything. I just wanted to get a hands-on quick review of it, of what it feels like, you know, the actual build quality of it. And it's just incredible. What I'll do is all the stats for it, I'll put down in the description, but I'll also put some links to videos down there so you guys can get an idea of what this phone can do with the extras that you can attach to it. There's a couple of really good reviews out there. And rather than try and do that stuff myself, I'll just put links to those videos. You can go and check them out yourself. But my first hands-on opinion of it, it's a bit heavy. It's a bit of a beast, but it's beautifully built. Absolutely beautifully built. The quality of it feels incredible. You know, it's absolutely wonderful. What I'll do is over the next few days, like I say, I'll get it fired up. And we'll test out the cameras. We'll do a bit of night vision filming with it, a bit of day filming with it, take some pictures and what have you, and we'll review the camera. And yeah, we'll see how we go from there. But yeah, do I think this could be like the ultimate biker phone, travel phone, rally phone, festival phone? Well, the fact that it's got a built-in power pack, yeah. The fact that it's very strong and durable in regards to, you know, for a biker phone, absolutely fantastic. Biker mechanic phone, fantastic. The fact you can fix an endoscope and that to it. It's got this incredibly bright light on the back. I mean, that's 1,000 lumens. So if you break down anywhere, it's not going to be half a dozen people crowding around with all their phones with their silly little lights on trying to illuminate something. This will do it all on its own. Absolutely incredible. But yeah, it is heavy phone. It feels like it weighs about 1.5 pound. But yeah, so keep your eyes out. I'm going to be doing some reviews for this phone in the very, very near future. And when I go away, I'll do some stuff with it while I'm away, and then I'll give you a proper full-on review of it. But like I say, down description, I'll put some links to some really good reviews that have been done for this video, for this phone. And yeah, and all the stats and everything I'll put down in the description. You go and check out the links. I think this could well be the ultimate biker phone. But we'll soon find out when I test it out. For now, yeah, I'm going to go and have a little tinker with this now. Go and load on, go and put some of the apps on it that I want. This is bare bones, you know, it's proper Android 13. It hasn't got no makers overlay like some of them do, like with the Xiaomi, because I've got a Xiaomi Redmi Note, and they put their own overlay, although that's running Android 13. They put their own overlay in it, and you've got a load of bloatware, which I ended up taking out. But this comes with absolutely no bloatware on it, and yeah, and it's stock Android 13. Anyway, I'm going to stop rabbiting now. I've opened it up and had a look at it. It feels fantastic. The quality of it is absolutely fantastic. The finish on it is amazing. And yeah, I'll do some filming with it and test it out. Do a live stream maybe on Sunday with it as well, so we can check out what it's like when doing live stream with it. And yeah. And I'll get back to you in, over the coming days and weeks, when we test this thing out and put it through its paces. So you all stay safe, and I'll catch you another day, another way. And thank you to Yin at Ulefone. Thank you very much, mate. Greatly appreciated. Bye now.